I'd like for safety professionals to go away. I'd like it to be so integrated into the system, integrated into how we do work and who we are, that we really don't need safety professionals. And so on my Facebook page, it says, coaching my kids and loving my wife. Those are the things that I do for fun. I think my mom probably got me more prepared on how to deal with people, how to find great answers, great solutions. There's all kinds of questions out there. If you're a drywall leader, or if you're a concrete guy, or if you're a safety professional, your approach every day has to be the same. There's all kinds of leadership studies that will tell you that it's not what you say, it's what you do. So if you live this every day, and you ask in a positive way, why are we doing this? Show me how this supports free and open lines of communication, supportive leadership, personal commitment, and accountability. And you'd be amazed at what we can change. DPR Construction wanted to do it differently. They wanted to be the best. They didn't want anybody injured. They didn't know what that really meant. There was a company that wanted to change the way construction looked. And here was a little piece that I might have been able to fit in. I mean, safety wasn't my background. But I think I wanted to do things differently, too. I brought OSHA out to projects. I remember in the early days of DPR, that freaked a lot of people out. The cool thing is it never freaked any of the management committee out. When we first started, we were measuring by lost time injuries, right? And we started talking about not having accidents on job sites. That was way before anybody else was doing it. They were still talking about, and their measurement was, how many lost time injuries did we have? And so when we started talking about, we don't think we have to have any accidents on any job sites. I mean, I get asked this at various groups that I interact with and speak at. You know, what one thing would we do different? And to be honest with you, you could sort of wipe our safety manual right off the... And if we were to become one thing and do one thing really well, it would be to plan, to be world-class planners. And so when you start approaching life and things that way, where you're looking for what happened before and how can I prevent it from happening to somebody else, or how can I prevent it from happening at all, it just opens up lots of opportunities. I think we've changed the language at DPR. I mean, we set the standard, right? We're not perfect. There's still lots of room here. But when you're a company of our size and our offices are all over the United States, and you can work at an injury rate that's just slightly above or slightly below one, you're operating in some pretty rare air. That's an excellent group that's found some key things and are executing them. I'm hoping at some point we'll be so good at what we do and it's so integrated into who we are that safety professionals actually go away.
Safety at DPR Construction isn't about money. It's not about schedule. It's about people. It's about a company caring for their people. That's what this is all about. The goal or the mission is to run the safest job anywhere. And one of the measurements of that is no injuries. And it can be done. We can attain that goal by everyone working together, by looking out for one another, by carpenter looking out for plumber, plumber looking out for ironworker. Sheet metal people looking out for the drywallers, the laborers. It's a collective effort. It's about caring whether that person, and you should look at it that way, whether or not that person gets to go home and see their family, their mother, their husband, their wife. That's what this is all about. And really, that is what safety is all about. It is about you and your family.